Okay, I'm sorry, I couldn't hear you. Okay. Good morning, this is Reverend Betsy Singleton Snyder, and I want to welcome you, not specifically to Trinity United Methodist Church from our sanctuary, but from my home in Robinwood with my family, and I hope that you're tuning in with your family this morning. We're glad that you're here, no matter how you got here via online. We know we couldn't get in our cars very easily this morning. It's really a sheet of ice, and so it made it difficult and dangerous, and we want everybody to be warm and safe. So we decided this might be a wonderful option this morning. And we want to take a minute. If you have some candles in your home, don't have an Advent candle wreath, you can go get four candles of any kind, or just get two candles this morning, because we are in the second Sunday of Advent. And so we're going to light the candles this morning. And I've asked my oldest son, Penn, to give me a hand with that. We have our Advent wreath. We lit one already this week for the first week of Advent and kept that lit and with our boys and sang Away in a Manger this week. And so now I'm going to ask Penn, would you please light our first and second candle? Here's our first candle from last week. So we're going to go ahead and light that one, which... if we were in worship, we would already have that one lit when we came into the sanctuary. But now we want to light the second candle. Go ahead, Penn. Let's light this one. That's okay. There we go. Let me give you a hand. There we go. This is his first time to be an acolyte, so. Okay, great. So we've lit the second candle this morning. And that is wonderful, wonderful for us. Now, we've got a son here who's crying and fussing. We're not going to blow out these candles because this is not birthday time. This is waiting time. And so it makes it hard. Everybody wants to get fussy and do their own thing during this season. But what we really want to do is we want to observe and wait and be still. One of the things that we've been doing at our home, and I think probably most of us who have children, if you had children, you did this at some point when your kids were little. We've been reading some wonderful Christmas books. Like one of our favorites is Mortimer's Christmas Manger, about a mouse who discovers all about the story of Jesus. We read that one. And we read some secular ones too, which also have a wonderful message about waiting and about how hard it is to wait and how wonderful it is that we have each other in the waiting, especially when it gets stressful. And the sermon series that we have going on right now during Advent is about waiting and how hard it is to do that and to worship more fully, to spend less, to have a conspiracy, an Advent conspiracy, where we really make Christmas change the world again, and not so commercial, not so materialistic. So I love this book. It's called Llama Llama Holiday Drama. And we read this one a lot during this time of year because this little llama gets very stressed out, and we all do, and that's what it points to. And so that's kind of fun. And we just bought a brand new book called An Otis Christmas. And for people who have boys especially who like tractors, this is a wonderful story about Christmas and about Christmas stars. So, we just had a child fall off the couch. You okay, sweetie? Are you okay? Okay, I think we're all okay. But those are some wonderful books. And one of the other books that we use, Mr. Paul, our children's minister, provided all our families with this book called The Wonders of His Love. And so the scripture reading for today from this book of Advent verses and Advent activities is from Micah 5:2. Boys, come here. Just come here so you can see and listen. It's almost time for we're going to do our offering. The scripture from Micah 2 is, "But you, O Bethlehem, you shall come forth for me, one who is to be ruler in Israel, whose coming forth is from of old, from ancient of days." And that's from Micah 5:2. And so, boys, one of the things, be careful there, one of the things that this reminds us of is that the Lord loved us and gave us the world and filled it with the wonders of that love. And then we messed it up. We do things. This morning we had a fight in our house, didn't we? Somebody got tripped up and then somebody hit, and it kind of got a little nasty here after 3 days in your home cooped up. It's a little bit stressful. So we know that we started disobeying God, even though God gave... Watch out, watch out. You're about to burn yourself on the candle, sweetheart. I'm so sorry. Stay away from the candle, honey. That's dangerous.
I smell something.
That's your hair. That's your hair. He said he smells something. It's because you got too close to the... It's a little close here, proximity-wise, with four of us. So... Anyway, things went awry, as they do, and as you can see, but God made us a promise that someday, that a Savior would come. And that's what we keep waiting for, and it's so hard to wait, especially for little people, but also for big people. So, boys, at this time, we're going to take our Advent offering for Trinity Kids.
The candles out.
We're not going to blow them out right now. Okay, let's give our dimes. Everybody's got a dime, I think. Mommy and Daddy will supplement that. You'll put that in, boys. I've got some other boys here. You going to put your offering in, Aubrey? Okay, well, we've got at least part of our offering in. So, Mr. Paul, thank you for the offering envelopes. And, boys, you can go upstairs with Dad now. Because I've got some things to say to the big people. Thank you. We're not going to blow them out. You can blow them out at the very end, okay? So, anyway, I hope some of you are feeling a great sense of relief that you don't have four children. Okay, so y'all go up with Dad. Everybody go up with Dad. At the end of this service, mini service and devotional time, thank you. We're going to post something on our Facebook and maybe website, but for sure Facebook, by Glennon Doyle Melton, who's the author. She wrote the book Carry On Warrior, which I think a lot of you would really enjoy. But she's going to be in this video clip talking about Advent, and the theme of that little video is called Be Still and Look. Be Still and Look. And we couldn't organize it today to get it to you while we were streaming live, but it's a wonderful, wonderful way to think about being quiet and being still as the focus of this Advent time. You know, I want to tell you two quick stories. The first is, you know, how hard it is to wait for Santa. I brought, this is my Santa that I had when I was a really little girl. And we always pulled him out, and he was part of the waiting. And as I waited, one year I really wanted something that was very popular at the time, and it was a new thing. It was called an Easy Bake Oven. And what I learned from that is that even when you get an Easy Bake Oven, you have to prepare the ingredients. And even though the ingredients were just this powdered, you know, sugary concoction pre-done, then we put water in it and we stirred it up and we made it, and then we put it in the oven, which was basically a light bulb, and then we had to wait and watch it rise, and slowly there was some kind of a cake that we had, but we had to wait. And I've noticed with my cooking this week, the last few days, whether we've made cream cheese Danish one morning or cheese sausage balls, and the boys rolled them out for me, they are always asking, how much longer? How much time do we have to wait? When's it going to be done? It's a constant game of waiting. And I think a first experience of baking teaches you that, no matter what your age. I want to tell you another story about, and by the way, I've been communicating with our staff members like Mr. Paul and Judy Gribble and some of those folks, and who all like to cook and eat, and we've been exchanging what we've been cooking. I made black bean soup and cornbread, actually, and that was so yummy Friday, and we still are warming that up, but we've been talking about how wonderful it's been to kind of slow down and cook and eat with our families. So in this waiting, I was thinking of another story, and this happened while I was in seminary, toward the end of my seminary career. When you're in seminary, there are a lot of causes that you're exposed to, and one of those for me was the issue of apartheid in South Africa. A lot of seminary students were very vocal about divestiture of the institutions that they were in, of assets that those institutions held in South Africa, and looking for an end to apartheid. And that was one of the ways that people back then were attempting to bring some justice to that situation, even in a faraway place. And so it seemed like forever that Nelson Mandela, who had been, you know, the leader of the Black liberation movement, that he had been in prison on Robben Island, I think like 26 years was total. And so I remember one morning I was driving to my church. I was serving a youth group, and I was headed that way. I had the radio on, and it was announced that after, you know, almost 30 years, that this leader had been released from prison. And I thought about the waiting and the waiting of it, and I have continued to think about that over the years. Could I wait for 26, 27 years in a prison environment of hard labor and continue to keep faith that God was with me and that freedom would someday come as a political prisoner? Would I be able to do that? Would I be able to hold on? And I just remember feeling an amazing sense of that the world had suddenly been transformed and changed after an incredibly long, long wait. And so I was reflecting on that this week with the release of Mr. Mandela, and what he has meant to the freedom movement, not only in his own country, that brought together blacks and whites, but created a whole new country where people were united. And so I think that is a good thing to remember, along with the other ways that we wait. And we're waiting right now, I should say, in closing, for the streets to get better and the ice to get better, and for that to go away and to melt. But while we're here, while we're in our homes, and while we're together, let us continue, brothers and sisters, to enjoy the wait and to savor it and to look for signs of God's coming into our lives. It's been so good to be with you today. Don't forget, I showed the children's offering. Obviously, we're not going to be taking an offering today, so Trinity needs your gifts. Please go ahead and make a gift to Trinity. When you're able to, next Sunday or during the week this week. And go ahead and take that up in your home today with your children if you are online and have children worshiping with us this morning. And I would just say, finally, don't forget to check out on our Facebook Glennon Doyle Melton's video that I absolutely love called Be Still and Look. It's from a film group called The Work of the People. Be Still and Look. And so I leave you with that. Brothers and sisters, peace, and be still and look. I'm so glad you are with us for this second Sunday of Advent. Be safe and be warm. Thanks be to God.